Hello everybody. Now coming to the size, body size of the chordate phylum family members. Actually, despite their modest number of species, the chordates make a disproportionate contribution to the biomass of the earth. Nearly all of them are medium to large in size, whereas the vertebrates in particular are considerably large, and many of them are among the largest of living animals. The largest one is gigantic blue whale. Blue whale. The zoological name of blue whale is Balaenoptera musculus. Balaenoptera musculus, which grows to 35 meters long and 120 tons in weight. And it is the biggest known animal. The whales are the second biggest one. The geological name is Rhynodon typus. Reaches a length of 15 meters and it is second biggest vertebrate after whale. And the smallest fish is Philippine goby, measuring only 10 millimeter long. So you can see that from the smallest, which is 10 millimeter long, to the highest, which is 35 meters long. There is a size variation in the body size, in the terms of body size, in chordate phylum. Now coming to the ecology part, the chordates are not only the largest animal in existence today, but ecologically also they are among the most successful in animal kingdom. They are able to occupy most kinds of habitats, and they have adapted themselves to more modes of existence than any other group, including the arthropods. They are found in the sea, in fresh water, in the air, and all parts of the lands from poles to the equator. Birds and mammals have been able to penetrate cold climate because they have a constant body temperature, something no other animals have. All lower chordates are marine, fishes are aquatic, and higher chordates are predominantly terrestrial. Saltwater amphibians are unknown. No birds live permanently in water, while some amphibians, reptiles, and mammals occur as permanent residents of water. While most tunicates are sessile, all chordates are free living, but all chordates are free living and none is strictly parasitic. No chordate animal is parasitic. All chordates are free living. The chordates are probably the most conspicuous and best known group in the entire animal kingdom, partly because of their large size and partly because of the important role they perform in their ecosystems. They are of primary interest because man himself is a member of the group. Because we belong to the chordate group, that's why this group has been studied extensively in comparison with other animal groups. From a purely biological viewpoint, also, the chordates are interesting because they illustrate so well the broad biological principles of evolution, development, and relationship. Thank you. In the next section, we will learn the fundamental characters of chordates.